around the place. Thanks for joining us once again. We present you another match from the Beyond Wrestling Studio taping at the CZW Academy. If you want to watch the match without commentary, by all means, click the link in the video description. Head over to the Beyond Wrestling YouTube channel. Make sure to subscribe to Beyond Wrestling and CZW on YouTube. Now, an interesting story heading into this match. Originally, it was supposed to be Anthony Stone teaming with JT Dunn against Tabernacle Team, one of the fastest rising tag teams in Beyond Wrestling, and Tabernacle Team going up against two of New England's best. Unfortunately, JT Dunn suffering an injury in his match with Jesse Vane earlier in the taping. So Butch Belmar, who was defeated by Christina Von Erich, what an opportunity to rectify that situation, pick up a win. Teaming with an unfamiliar partner against familiar opponents, that's Belmar and Tabernacle Team, all three of those competitors from Canada. Belmar, very physical encounter with Christina Von Erich. Almost gonna wonder what condition he's in coming into this matchup. And really going up against a well-oiled machine, Tabernacle Team. I'm gonna say that Stone and Belmar are at a serious disadvantage. Belmar, though, showing some of his wrestling ability, a little bit more of a straightforward approach than what we've seen from him since his debut from Beyond Wrestling. I mean, he's just a gross guy. Tries to psych out his opponents. Spit on him. I've seen him eat cigarettes before. Right there. Can spitting in his opponent's face. A third time. And Matthew St. Jacques not standing for it. And as a result, Bucks Belmar no longer standing. Just stomping a mud hole in him, as the expression goes, as Matthew St. Jacques now put his hand in the mouth of Bucks Belmar. He might just rip off his jaw. Tabernacle Team, two bruisers from Canada. There we see the penis attack from Belmar, trying to use his speed. He's certainly not going to outpower Matthew St. Jacques or Thomas Dubois. At the opening to tag in Anthony Stone. Stone just got bum rushed into the corner. Stone trying to prevent any separation whatsoever, able to bypass his opponent in the corner. Caught him with that flipping drop kick. The back body drop and a kick on the way down for good measure. Stone rushed right into the pin. Matthew St. Jacques easily kicking out. Stone with that front face lock applied. Takes his opponent over the corner. And Belmar with the wherewithal to tag himself in. And I think that if Stone and Belmar can use the quick tags to isolate Matthew St. Jacques, that's going to work to their advantage. A bit of a disrespectful pin from Bucks Belmar. Wouldn't expect anything else. Tags in Anthony Stone once again. Of course, all four of these competitors fighting in front of CZW officials here today.
I wear gloves, that's all right, man.
It looked like Anthony Stone deliberating with Bucks Belmar. They should have been dropping the elbow. Thomas Dubois! Not into the antics of Bucks Belmar. He's into kicking ass. That's what he's doing right here. Now directing traffic, marking those French orders, ones that I cannot decipher. Bucks Belmar may be able to, but Anthony Stone did not. Even still, Anthony Stone fighting off Thomas Dubois, sent to the floor. Bucks Belmar just chucking Matthew St. Jacques. Anthony Stone checking on Bucks Belmar, trying to help him get back up to his feet. It was clear the ring of him. Stone with eyes to the back of his head with that drop kick, knocked down Matthew St. Jacques. Stone going for the double stomp, caught up in that ring skirt. And now Tabernacle Team, the bruisers from Canada. Oh! Bucks Belmar trying to save his partner, sent face first into the post. Now it's Matthew St. Jacques isolating Anthony Stone. Tabernacle Team, two young, hungry guys, tremendous upside. They've really been making rounds over the past year, especially branching into the United States. And saw them compete against worst case scenario at a Dragon Gate USA tryout at WrestleCon. And just the progress since then has been astounding. We're almost going to wonder if it's a matter of time before we see Tabernacle team tearing it up with some of the other teams on the CZW roster, like the Juicy Product, like Blackout, like Ohio's for Killers, like the Beaver Boys. Certainly bring an incredibly different flavor than what we're used to seeing. Just straightforward, no-nonsense, smash-mouth wrestling. Nothing pretty, but it's certainly effective. Kevin Quinn with his hands full today, being intimidated by the wrestlers, doing his best to maintain order. Sometimes in a tag match like this, it almost seems like it would be better to assign multiple officials if only we had the resources. Snap suplex goes right over to the pin. Matthew St. Jacques with the boot up. Tagging himself in. And they have isolated the smallest competitor in this match, Anthony Stone. Again, bending the rules to their advantage. We saw the fish hooks before going to this chin lock. Just trying to crank the neck. One hand underneath the chin. One hand on top of the head. Anthony Stone likes to build momentum off those ropes, connect with his opponents with a number of strikes. Right here we see the reversal of the Irish whip. Elbow to the back of the face. Stone might be out on his feet. Just sending him face first with that gourd buster. Wow, off the ropes. Oh, caught him right in the back of the head. That Northern Lariat. Wow, starting to get frustrated. Now just trying to suffocate his opponent. Not even choking him at the throat. Trying to block the nose and the mouth. Bucks Belmar doing his best to try and rally Anthony Stone over his corner. Cannot absorb too many more of these shots. Now Stone trying to get his feet up. He kicks off Matthew St. Jacques. Caught Dubois with a couple elbows. Sent Tabernacle the team into each other. Got him hooked. Kicking down Dubois and using that momentum to connect with that DDT. Stone is very, very resilient. Quickly realizing that he's in the wrong corner. He might have to get past both of his opponents before he can make the tag. Anthony Stone turned inside out with that clothesline. And Bucks Belmar having to push off Matthew St. Jacques to break up the pin. Get another tag from Tabernacle to team. Just a body avalanche in the corner and a clothesline. These two are so physical. That gut wrench with the float over. And Thomas Dubois presumably talking shit in French to Bucks Belmar. Even after a very impressive sequence of maneuvers, stringing together those gut-wrench throws, Anthony Stone still kicking out. You gotta think that's starting to get underneath the skin of TDT. Stone somehow needs to find a way out of this waist lock. Caught him with the kick on the top of the head. Anthony Stone's gotta dig deep right here. He's only a few feet away. It's gonna seem like miles at this point. Just inches away, the fingertips grazing. But Stone managing to land on his feet, trying to jump over. Matthew St. Jacques, there was going to be nobody to tag to as Dubois pulled Bucks Belmar off the corner. Nothing pretty about that slam, plucking Anthony Stone out of midair. for someone spine first into the mat. And now again going after the nose. Tabernacle team undefeated coming into this matchup. What an upset would be for Anthony Stone and Bucks Belmar to pick up the victory. But Anthony Stone has made a career in Beyond Wrestling of picking up the upset victories. Defeated the number one ranked Johnny Cockstrong at the time. Gave Mark Angel his first ever loss. Oh, caught him with the kick. And finally making the tag. Here comes the freshest man, Bucks Belmar. Flailing around the ring, hitting everything that's moving. Turning his body into a projectile. And again, Bucks Belmar's on fire. Oh, a miscommunication from Tabernacle team. Dubois sidestepped, two knees to the chin. You hear the other wrestlers coming alive. Everybody loves a good comeback story. Tabernacle team on the ropes. St. Jacques able to tag himself in. Oh, just dumped him right on his head with that DDT. What is going on right here? Wow, look at the elevation of that moonsault. But Belmar with the wherewithal to get out of the way. And the gut buster trying to drive all the wind out of his opponent. And the double stomp. Is that going to do it? One, two, three. Oh. Just milliseconds away from pulling the upset victory. Handing Tabernacle team their first ever loss here in Beyond Wrestling. Now Bucks Belmar telling Anthony Stone, climb to that top buckle. Perhaps Stone should have listened to him, having trouble finding his footing. Thomas Dubois able to catch Anthony Stone. Oh, but caught with the crucifix driver. What a counter out of Stone. And the leg drop. Just a glancing blow, but was that enough? Oh, Belmar's not the legal man. Paying for it. St. Jacques trying to knock him out from a vulnerable position. Now we see the body blows out of Anthony Stone. Trying to numb up that arm. Stone went for the kill shot. St. Jacques out of the way. That running body attack in the corner. St. Jacques starting to lose his focus right here. Anthony Stone up on that second rope, but able to bypass him on the way down. Pulling him off the mat, scooping him up. Ah, oh, right in the buckle. Stone is done. Stone smart enough to roll out of the ring. But unfortunately, Bucks Belmar just deposited all of his body's weight, crashing down to the top of his head. And Tabernacle team picking up the victory, staying undefeated. Although Anthony Stone and Bucks Belmar gave him a hell of a lot more fight than I think that what they were prepared for here today. Thomas Dubois, Matthew St. Jacques. A force to be reckoned with, a tag team to keep your eye out for, especially as they start branching out more in the United States.